Hi, a YouTuber was brought to my attention called Hitman Notoriety. He's a tiny YouTuber, subscriber-wise, otherwise he's a big-ass bearded grown man with big ambitions. He wants to help people get rid of their common sense one video at a time. He claims space travel is a hoax. I don't typically bother with these people, although at least he doesn't think the Earth is flat. But he used one of my videos to prove that the plasma thrusters are fake. In case you don't know, a plasma thruster is a type of propulsion engine that creates thrust using plasma. And plasma is just ionized gas.
This guy is proving ion propulsion doesn't work in a vacuum. So, if NASA's claiming they're using ion propulsion out in space for their little satellites flying around in and out of planets' orbits and shit, well, they're lying to you. No moon landings, no rovers on Mars, nothing outside of our atmosphere, period. Because how are you actually moving it around?
No.
You're just going to see this spin and stop. And it's f***ing hilarious. Slowly pulling the vacuum down, still has the ion. The ability to create the back pressure.
No!
Yeah, slowing down, isn't it? There you go. Gee. See, I guess NASA can get a rocket and a spacecraft to move around out in space, but you can't even get a f***ing paperclip to spin in a vacuum chamber? You just understand NASA's a big Disney World presentation and they do nothing whatsoever out in space.
I see now. Oh, I was wrong. I did the experiment myself and I didn't see it. Everything NASA has been feeding us was just a part of a Mickey Mouse show. Making us poor taxpayers pour our money into space programs to enhance human life while all the money is being secretly used for wars and evil. This was sarcasm if you didn't pick it up. This guy is an idiot. What I showed in my video was my Tesla coil in vacuum and how my spinning wheel doesn't turn in vacuum because there is no air. By no means is this a plasma thruster. It does generate plasma at the end of the needle by ionizing the air. The ionized air glows and also heats up. It's the heat that expands the air and pushes the needle around. It could have worked even if I put some heater element at the end of the needle. In vacuum, there is no expanding air, so it doesn't move. You might think in my Tesla coil, the needle was pushing out electrons and that should generate some thrust. But no, the electrons were moving in and out of the tip of the needle at 1 MHz frequency. Even if the needle was pushing electrons out one way, they are virtually weightless, so they wouldn't generate any significant thrust. In plasma thrusters, they have a tank of some sort of liquid gas that they turn them into the ionized gas atoms, which are incredibly heavier than the electrons. Then they accelerate them through some electric field to super high speed and shoot them out of the end of the nozzle that generates thrust. In my Tesla coil, there is no material pouring out of the needle to generate thrust. So stop spreading lies using my videos. And that's not all he did. He took one of cody’slab videos to prove that you can't even have regular propulsion in vacuum. Can you believe it? He took advantage of our Cody. Cody is one of our most knowledgeable, honest, handsome, lovable YouTube scientists. In Cody's video, he is burning material with his laser, showing how material like gunpowder that has its own oxidizer and doesn't need air to burn, in fact doesn't ignite in the vacuum.
Gunpowder did not ignite?
It can't get any better than this. This is the latest from Cody's lab. What it shows in this experiment is you can't have any kind of chemical reaction go down with force behind it with a vacuum placed. You can't have any kind of propulsion go down in a vacuum.
That's a no-go on burn.
this video should be entitled Proof NASA is Utter Fraud. Thanks, Cody. Right on, man. You know, he's not actually telling you rockets aren't working in space. It takes sharp people to figure it out, clearly.
That's why I designed a new shirt from one of my old quotes. There is no escape from the enemy within. And one of the biggest enemies is ignorance. You must constantly face it and fight it. If you'd like to spread the message and support what I do, you can get yours from the link below. Let me think about it a little bit and see if I can come up with a solution for NASA so they can use combustion in space. Imagine we have a tank of combustible material and another tank of liquid oxygen. And then we mix them together in a third chamber, pressurize them, burn them there, and then we let out the burning gas from a small nozzle at the end to create thrust. And the back pressure of the burning gas can keep this chamber pressurized so that the ignition can keep going. Oh, that was easy. NASA, design is attached. Please stop the Mickey Mouse show and let's get to the moon. Cody himself did another video to prove this. He used model rocket engines to experiment. First, he showed in vacuum those rocket engines don't ignite. Then all he did was to put everything in a plastic bottle to keep the pressure up for the ignition to keep going. So then we had liftoff in vacuum. I bet if you put the gunpowder in a glass bottle and close the lid, and then put a tiny hole in the lid, put the whole thing in a vacuum chamber and suck the air from inside and outside the bottle, then burn the gunpowder with a laser, it will pressurize inside this bottle enough to keep the ignition going and push the air out of this hole. Maybe another test for Cody to do? Wink wink. But Hitman doesn't stop there. In another video he says, even if you have ignition in the vacuum of space, it doesn't generate thrust. The title of his video, Checkmate Science, where he single-handedly brings science to its knees.
What I'm basically throwing out here, and others have deduced, is that rockets don't work in space.
Why?
And it's really clearly evident the reason why they launch them down next to the oceans. You know, why don't they launch rockets off of mountaintops? I mean, it'd be more cost-effective. I mean, point A to point B is a lot shorter distance to travel.
What? How is it cheaper moving everything required to launch a rocket on top of a mountain, and for what? Space station is 408 kilometers above Earth, and Moon is 385,000 kilometers away. How does moving entire launch station and logistics up 5 kilometers on top of a crazy mountain make things better?
And in all reality, everything's functioning, you know, everything's actually moving around with voltage potentials.
What? So if I throw a rock at someone's head, is it the voltage that kills them or the current?
The magnetism comes after this pressure moves around. You've got such a huge lie, so many people participating in a theme park, once you fundamentally understand that there is a person underneath that Mickey Mouse costume. Buzz Aldrin is an actor.
Buzz Aldrin, I always knew it was you in the Mickey Mouse costume at Disneyland.
One small step for man.
And a lot of this stuff they do in swimming pools that are very, very large, the water's very pristine, and it gives you the illusion of them floating around out in space, when in all reality they're on Earth, swimming around in pools. They're just filming everything underwater. It's f***ing hilarious.
It's hilarious to you, huh? Let's not forget swimming skills are key to space travel.
This is the Achilles heel of every single space program on this planet. Any satellite out there they claim is flying around? No! Because it's impossible once again. 14 pounds per square inch, we'll start off here, right? If you're next to the ocean, we'll just say the highest atmospheric pressure to the lowest atmospheric pressure. This pressure, as the rocket climbs, every single meter it rises in this atmospheric density once again, loses the ability to push. I got it down to where it terminates. There is no pressure, no friction, no drag. And it's just bar none in your f***ing face. I mean, the graph's right here.
You morons, the graph's right there. Are you blind? I see his problem. He thinks a thruster can only thrust if it pushes against air, and in vacuum of space there is nothing to push against. And for that, I'll let my daughter electrocute to explain it to you.
According to Newton's third law, for every action there's an equal and opposite reaction. Here I have a mousetrap that I put on Lego wheels so it can move around easily.
Great. Very good.
Let me trigger it. See, it stays around the same area. I have taped three marbles together to put on the back of the mousetrap for it to throw them. See, the marbles shoot that way and the mousetrap jump the other way as the reaction. Similarly in space, a rocket has to shoot out tons of burning gases very fast. And in reaction, the rocket is pushed forward. And you don't need any air for this to happen.
There, wasn't too hard, was it?
Looking at Saturn V rocket that took the Apollo spacecraft to the moon, this whole thing is the Apollo spacecraft that fits right on top of the rocket right there, so you can imagine how huge the rocket was. The rest of the rocket are the thrusters that pushed it to the moon. The total weight of the rocket at launch was 2.8 million kilograms, and the first stage was outputting 15,000 kilos per second at supersonic speeds.
At the end of just stage 1, after 2 minutes 42 seconds, the spacecraft was running at 7 times the speed of sound at an altitude of 62 kilometers. 30 to 40 kilometers above Earth, there is already no significant atmospheric pressure.
I would like anybody to prove me wrong, right?
You need proof? Okay. Every starry night I'm outside, I can see a few satellites passing above my head with naked eyes. Why don't I show you the brightest one, the International Space Station, or ISS?
Look at me. So I'm using my super old camera I have to try to record the International Space Station for you. This is the only camera I have that has some decent zoom, and hopefully it can capture something. I have this International Space Station detector app that will tell me exactly when and where it will appear in the sky. Tonight it's gonna come from west and go to east right above my head. Of course, I highly doubt it if this camera can pick up any features of the space station like the solar panels, but it can record it. Anytime now, it should be coming out from behind those buildings. Oop, there it is. There it is. It's going. Yep, that's it. That's it. That's the space station. Well, it's so bright, everyone would think it's just the airplane passing, but it's the space station. And that's not the only one you can see either. So far I've seen like two other satellites passing above my head, but this camera can't capture them because they are too dim.
That video quality sucked. It was the ISS I was showing, but maybe I lied and zoomed onto some random star. So install your own ISS detector or satellite tracker app on your phone, go outside and see them for yourself, especially the ISS because it's the brightest. And now that we are at least in orbit, all it takes for us to get to space from orbit is to throw a basketball towards Earth at high speed, and that's enough to push us into space. As always, thank you for watching, and specially thank you for supporting my channel at patreon.com so I can bring these videos to you. And if it doesn't kill you, please like, share, and subscribe. Because what doesn't kill you makes you stronger!